finally. So, what we have here, ladies and gentlemen, is a classic 5v5 between the Curse of the Abyss over here on the left, and the blue team, and Team Nobody over here on the right, who will be the purple or red team, depending on whether or not you're using colorblind mode. I haven't actually seen Team the Curse of the Abyss play. I've seen Team Nobody play, and they do some really interesting things that I brought up earlier. So, I really don't know what to expect.
The classic LSO Sunburn, you know.
Yep,
not a big surprise there. And it's banned from Diana. They don't want that bursty effect.
Nobody's, of course, banning Sun because they're not burst pick. As Petro probably banning Alistair and Blitzcrank because they're looking to play a more passive support lane. Morgana banned because she's just stupid. And same thing with Malphite.
Kind of interesting in the Diana ban because after the nerf to her, a lot of people thought that she was not, that she went from tier 1 down to trash tier, you know. And I played her post-nerf, and she's still not that bad.
Right, her base damage isn't too badly nerfed. It was more the ratios that got nerfed than anything.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, Tucker picking his Taric, which is amazing.
He's gonna dazzle everybody.
Yeah, with his amazing manliness.
His bottom gem and gray.
Auto-lock
and Leona pick, a personal favorite of mine on bottom lane.
Yep.
Very, very
aggressive
still lane. Okay, there's a Contemplation of Graves. That'll be a safe pick. Oh!
Evelynn.
The troll pick from Evelynn.
not necessarily a troll pick.
Yeah, I've seen a few good Evelynn plays, but overall, she's...
You've seen the buff play mid lane. So,
right. He's probably just doing that to throw him off.
Probably. Amumu. If they lock in that Amumu, they'll have a really, really high initiate team with both Taric and Amumu.
Right. You get the double smash, double stun.
And of course, that'll make very, very easy ganks from bot lane.
Maokai in the house!
And maybe even a Syndra.
This would be a first for Syndra being played in Fever tournaments since he just came out.
I think it would be much safer to play it with the face. Because Syndra is such high skill cap, I don't think anybody can play her at a high level. Or even
I've only seen video footage of her, but she seems like to be all over the place.
Yeah. Looks like Karthus. Very, very safe late game pick. But wrecks everything with his Q. And he's not
good. If Karthus gets fed early, it's pretty much game over, so.
Ahri being thought about. Ahri is a very strong counter to Karthus.
Ooh, and Nidalee.
I kind of doubt he would go with Nidalee. They already have their top laner, so. Assuming they pick Barry.
And right now, this looks pretty strong on the defensive end of things. I mean, they have one of the more tanky ADs with Graves. They have Taric and Amumu for basically total CC control. And it looks like Ahri and Darius, so they're going to have the huge nukers on top of it have the CC champ, so.
And they have very good, they're good at punishing people for getting caught with a taunt into a Darius pull, into a Mumu, and Taric stun. So if one of nobody's carries gets caught out by an Ahri taunt, they're dead. And of course, Kalgar playing Olaf. because what else would you expect Calvo to play? And
Kuno.
Kuno. So I'm gonna look at some runes and masters here, because we have about 3 minutes. I'm gonna look at Tagore's Olaf. Looks like he's running AD Quint, MR per level blue, armor and armor pen. So it's a pretty standard top lane page. Can we look at Masters here? Oh, we can look
I'm actually surprised he's going armor penetration instead of base AD, just due to the fact he has that 2 damage stat.
Yeah.
Well, no, that doesn't scale off AD, does it?
No, the 2 damage is just
a base flat amount.
2 damage. So with that Olaf Darius lane, Darius tends to pretty much wreck everything top lane. Looks like he's running flat AD, MR, armor, and attack damage.
Yeah, he's playing full flat, so he's going for the early game win.
Yeah. And if he...
Wait, is that a tier 1 rune that he has there?
Yeah, and he only has 3 yellow pages. So, looks like he's a pretty new player.
Maybe not a new player. I wouldn't bet he probably has a little bit under his sleeve, so... Unless he just wanted that even 12, you know?
So, looking at the mid lane matchup, it looks like Ahri is running mana regen, opting for mana regen and MR or an AP per level instead of health per level or magic resist. So she's going to be extremely squishy against that Karthus. And Karthus is running AP per level blue, AP per level yellows, health quintessences, and magic 10 red. So she is also running that
25 AP gain at level 18. Wow.
So Karthus is already supposed to open himself with glass cannons.
Late game glass cannons, though.
That's going to be that mid lane's going to be determined by how much damage junglers can do.
Although, the 78 extra health on Karthus, though, is going to help him a ton at that starting phase, because that's an extra AP skill shot from Ahri that he can take to the face.
Yeah, that's like one. That's 2 cuts from her orb, so. Malakai running move speed, AP blue, and attack speed red. So he has no magic resist whatsoever, so Ahri's gonna rip into shreds.
That's actually a pretty standard Malakai jungle build, though.
Right, he has the AP blue and started race.
Yeah, exactly. Although, typically, rather than getting movement speed, Quint, usually, you want to hit about 21 ability power just off your runes. Because in that, with 2 sapling tosses, and then the third one doing splash damage from the first attack and then the explosion, that'll kill the race instantly. So that one's going to take him a little bit longer to clear race and then go to his blue.
Cool. And my...
The spectator timer is different. Yeah. Just give it a second.
Did the spectator timer time out?
It was different in the 2, I think it was like a 50 second difference, so give it a minute. Worst comes to worst, you go out and we expect that to
be funny.
Yeah.
So, it looks like in that mid lane, it's gonna be very hit or miss to those mid laners. They're almost gonna have to get lucky with those Karthus keys.
There's so much AoE damage on both teams. Because of the Abyss, they have a little bit more AoE damage. For the most part, they're running pretty neck and neck in just about everything. If you look at it, both teams are well, first of all, both teams are really lacking sustain, so I would expect them all to come to lane with 13 health potions, because you want to outlane the other guy.
Yeah.
But, I mean, and looking at Recursive Abyss's team, the amount of, like, buffs that they have compared to Team Nobody is ridiculous. I mean, they have more than twice the amount of self-buffs that Team Nobody has right now.
Right. So it looks like, as far as the skin war goes, I have no idea who's going to win the skin war. I mean, for a second, Olaf, pretty boss. So is Blood Sun Paris.
You gotta hand it to Riot Games there.
Yeah, so it looks like Forsaken Abyss wins the skin war with that double skin bot lane. Ezreal is crying a little bit because he doesn't have a skin and Leona does.
You gotta look at the two team advantages. Abyss has the approach factor with Paris and Amumu, and then Ahri and Graves just keep from distance. Once the team fight starts, they have Darius to pull him in, basically cause havoc that way, or he could be more of an initiator to get the snares off. Whereas Team Nobody has basically Leona to go balls to the wall, you know, sword grab, and then once he initiates the fight, the rest of them can pretty much seal off an area and just fight it. So, basically, if Team Nobody gets the early advantage and the initiation, they will most likely win the fight.
Alright, so we are in-game. Items, lots and lots of boots, 3 pots.
Uh-oh, Amumu is taking a nap. What's up?
The mount I built, I'm looking at, that's pretty strange. I don't think I've ever seen a Maokai jungle go boots in 3 pots. Usually you get the health regen and then 2 potions.
Okay, so we have Karthus holding down the bottom line. It looks like they're both trying to initiate on the other's blue and nobody knows where each other are. Although, Abyss has warded their blue, so they would know when it's taken, whereas Team Nobody has not done anything about it. It's gonna be a double steal in blue. It's gonna be interesting with both teams collide getting back to their lanes, though. You're getting a little bit of flashing in the middle of your screen there.
Yeah, that's because I'm tabbed out. Should be fine now. It looks like the red team is being a little bit more aggressive. Team Abyss, they were going to wait to see if they could maybe get a pull off on the bot lane. But they're just going to go through those.
Abyss is now realizing that they may not know where the other team is until they actually go for blue buff. So, right now, Team Nobody in red is going in for the blue buff. Diaz is going to give himself away here. So is FaZe, now Nox, now Kalgar. So they know where 4 of Team Nobody is. And they're going to be coming across middle now, and you never know what's going to happen when they resort. So. There's a trade of blues there, so really no gain, no loss for either team. There is a little conflict in the upper jungle. It looks like nobody has gotten grab on.
Got
caught.
So, that is first blood for team.
Oh my god. Maokai.
Oh, and Maokai goes down.
Wow, that was just a little bit too ballsy.
I don't really understand that trade.
So now Ahri has blue buff, and Karthus is going to give up on life.
They have flood though, so they are up a little bit, but that was kind of an unnecessary death they could have avoided.
Yeah, and Ahri ended up with blue buff, so Karthus is going to be in trouble.
I think when you said
kill towards Ezreal down bottom. It was probably a turret stun with the follow-up from Graves coming in with his dash and shooting him right in the face before he could flip out, so.
I'm going to rewind, see if I can see that a little bit. So,
I told you about 230, yeah, somewhere there. A little way after that, but probably about 10 seconds jump.
Yep. Looks like they come around the wrong way and they just get caught and blown away.
Yeah, they come down the straight route and Ezreal pulls the flash, but then gets stunned by Tarek with the dazzle. And when he goes away that far, the stun is actually longer the longer the dazzle is in the air. So he just basically messed himself up there actually by flashing ahead of time.
So it looks like CS-wise, Team Nobody is very, very, very far behind. Ezreal has about a quarter as much CS as Graves, which I guess is to be expected. Calgary is kind of bullying Darius around.
Well, they've been out of lane for so long that they missed the first wave or two on each one, so they're going to be behind, you know, 200 per wave. So,
it's been Ari going back and buying a 4-minute, 30-second KG. That's going to put her even more further ahead of Karthus.
Wow. Right now, they've taken the early two kills and the upper farm. Oh, and
Calgary takes the kill.
Getting a kill as Olaf and Mumu does take the kill right behind it. A one-for-one trade up top, but top lane is now going to suffer from that.
Oh my gosh. Jeez. He's gonna die to, he died to golems. Oh,
classic.
Losing a red buff.
What is wrong with Team Nobody? I have never seen them this off early game.
So many minor screw-ups.
Yeah.
And I mean, they're fine for now, but those will add up in the long run.
Well, as long as they don't continue to make these mistakes, they'll probably even out within about a 10-minute period. But it's a 1.5k lead right now, or give or take, and that is going to hurt them severely. And the Moon is doing a nice job to counter jungling them. They're going to try going for the Karthus here momentarily.
Oh no, Moon gives up, borrows the creep, and walks away.
It looks like Abyss is pushing a little hard on all lanes right now. It sounds like they have the aggressive advantage, but the only problem here is that if Mirka is in position from jungle, he can severely cripple them and slow them down with his movement speed coming in.
Oh, Zeus is caught in his jungle. Ari's coming up.
Oh, it's a
can you get the taunt? One more dash.
One with a level advantage.
Yeah, that's a very dead tree. Noxious trying to see if he can clean it up from that.
A 3-on-2 here. Slight advantage to Abyss. A 4-on-2.
Karthus should be pushing out mid lane. Is he pushing out mid lane? No, he's just farming.
Without that push, they would have needed his extra, you know, firepower there to really take advantage on the bottom there. He's not doing a good job.
Oh, as Tetra dying to the ignite from Noxious.
Good work on handling the pressure there. Now they're getting jumped by all the minions, so they're going to have to force, you know, Pain there taking their last hit while the rest of the team is. Oh, and Zeus goes in. Level 2 is getting hit by everything.
Oh, and that, the Grave Buckshot takes out all of his health. Well, quarter of his health.
Wow.
The Karthus assault.
Smoke screen excellently placed. And Karthus coming in for the kill with his ult.
Oh, and Noxious picking off Yamumu, giving Ezreal a blue buff, which could turn this bot lane around.
Yeah. And now the score goes 5v5, but there's still a 1,000 gold lead for blue team. So, will they catch up in this little skirmish?
It looks like top lane, Kalgar is really zoning to Darius. I mean, he's losing CS too, but Darius is not doing so well.
They've got people on top, so...
He's going extremely aggressive.
A nice pink ward to counter that top green on the blue team.
And he also has a red pot to help against the Karg Assault or the Barrier Assault.
Right.
Extremely aggressive. He really wants to win that top lane right now.
And they're still a one-day lead by the blue team, so they've been doing a really nice job of keeping that gold count up.
Goose now hitting level 3. Finally getting a point in that Arcane Smash.
9 minutes in, getting level 3. Excellent.
As we are trying to steal the blue buff, but about 15
that's
seconds
late.
That's
a nice job of getting the Amumu down a little bit in health, though, so.
Yep. They now have the timer on that blue buff, so they can attempt to invade that.
Nobody's probably feeling a little pressured at this point to try and catch up. They may not know that they're down in gold at this point, but they definitely know that they're not doing a good job by having their Mayo Kai still at level 3, so.
Yeah. Yeah, Goose is not doing very well. Looks like Olaf might be able to pick off Darius.
He took some really big risks, so they really have not, taken off for what he needs.
Oh, Olaf picking off Darius and dying to the dot.
What was Goose doing?
No idea, but he's dead now, so.
Oh, and Ari's coming in from the backside. That's what he said, anyway.
That's a very fed Ari. That's 4 kills.
That Ari is going to be a hyper fury. I can already see it. Unless she gets shut down now, she will be very, very aggressive at the end of the game.
Cage is up to 175 gold for her.
For most of the gold.
Yeah, Ari has quite
just
a bit of gold.
Just past 3,500 gold. Next in line is Graves at 3,100.
Osmond, are you watching from the stream, or did you join the Spectator
Appliance? I'm watching the stream right now.
Join the Spectator Appliance, that'll remove a few seconds away.
Fine. Let's see if I spectate Polly. Fine.
Spectate Axie.
Oh, I can't spectate a spectator, John. That's it, who?
Noxious? Who's the Noxious?
Yes.
Or Zeus. You have Zeus, that is, probably.
Exactly, a zero player.
Nope, that's Cronius. Not Noxious.
Well, me and Cronius are really good at bottom lane with Leo and Azeal. We started the crave of the Sunshine team, so.
Azeal taking the kill off of Olaf.
Beautiful Leona ult. Mm-hmm. Oh, that was amazing.
I'll have to watch it here in a moment. I'm getting it up now.
Oh man, I wasn't watching bot lane. But top lane, Olaf taking the kill, or Darius taking the kill off of Olaf, and then Karthus ulting for the free kill off of the well health Darius. I'm gonna rewind.
Looking like a Mumu and Ari are gonna take down Ezreal.
Yeah,
probably Leona.
Ari's gonna get. Oh, Mumu taking one kill. That's death to Leona. So I'm gonna go back a little bit.
Health White is just doing such an amazing job on this Ari.
So we got Oaken pushing hard in the middle, trying to get that early map control that the team desperately needs at this point. Can't quite make it, but he puts a huge dent in it. So basically on the next push, he could probably take down Tower. Mumu going for the seal at blue right now. We'll probably take it as, Ezreal, Leona, and Maokai are inside their base. Ooh, Amumu is actually going to give it to Ari. Probably called it out first. And there's the still, and they leave the one golem, but they will find that right away.
I'm going to give Ezreal the timer on their blue.
Yeah. It looks like they may go for Dragon here, so they're pink warding it, so they've just removed the sight of blue team at Dragon, and it seems that they're pinging to signal that they want to do something, so. Palgor doing a nice job getting that 2 damage off whenever he can to the Darius. And it's a 1-on-1 fight at top.
Oh,
right.
He's gone.
Oh,
and
my God.
He wins the fight, and he
annihilates both of them.
Ignite, of course. Destroying everybody.
I mean, ignite, Funeral Prey, I mean, that just, that hurts from Darius.
Are you stealing the red buff? I'm contested.
You know, I think at this point, Darius would probably do better to take Maokai and just throw him into a lane. Because he's so far behind, he can't go into his jungle because he gets killed by a Moomoo.
Oh, and he gets the take, though, from Ari. No, Ari
gets away with it.
How did Ari do that? I saw the smite go off from Darius, and might have said I had just enough health.
Still on cooldown. The smite's still on cooldown.
Ah, gotcha, yeah, I just noticed. And smite just coming up.
Buddy, just went up with some Lucana.
Amumu, Poland, Lugol, and when he takes it with smite.
Of course, because Ari already has one, currently.
Bottom lane is getting pushed a little bit. Ezreal making a nice shot onto Graves.
Gold-wise, they're pretty even bot lane, only about 75 gold difference, or 150 gold difference.
Leona making a move on bottom. Ezreal almost one-hitting. Graves falls to the Ezreal. Impossible double kill here for Noxious, but he misses two. Leona's heading back after a nice day's work down bottom. Middle is getting pushed up for blue team. He's putting a little pressure on Karthus so that he just can't sit back and farm all day.
Ari definitely wants that Karthus.
Oh,
once their ult comes back up.
Huge double on top. Did a really nice overall the damage from now just totally takes him out.
Oh, and Noxious getting caught bot lane between Altaric and Amumu.
Really, you cannot stay down there that long without your support in lane with you. I mean, that just, it hurts so much. And folks
and
in the middle
are
going
to die.
He's going to ult here, most likely. He's
Maokai
going to pick up the kill. Very nice play.
Almost getting Zeus. Not that he's worth any gold, but almost. Almost
he's
picking up.
He's doing a nice job of holding her down, doing enough damage to get that Karthus ult kill.
But right now, Zeus is at the point.
Oh, Zeus getting caught by Moomoo.
And this does not look good. One more tantrum. There it is.
Amumu's just trying to build him up, too.
But right now, Ryan is playing the victory, yeah. So.
Maokai's at the point where he can start dodging people again, even though he has such a level disadvantage. With his ultimate, that's going to help keep some of the pressure off of him and pull some of the damage off him and his team. And
it's almost a 4K lead by Blue Team and Abyss at this point. I mean, it's going to get tougher and tougher to come back from Purple Team unless they can severely outfarm Blue. And Graves is almost 400 damage with his buckshot.
Noxious just can't trade with him anymore.
No,
you go all in or you don't go in at all.
Well, Graves has, he's going probably for the IE first with the way he's building. Whereas Ezreal's taking a different route, going Bloodthirster for that just base AD damage. Looks like he's going for a steam second so that his Q is going to hit like a truck upcoming here, probably in the next few minutes. We've got a Moomoo moving around Dragon, probably just scoping out things in the jungle. Kalgoor taking top golem just for that little extra money and level. Militai's heading back to buy more. Amumu possibly making a move in middle here. Places a ward in their jungle so that they can get a huge advantage if they don't spot that. Moomoo coming in the middle, missing
the damage off, but the ult.
Oh, what a nice ult. And tanking the tower for Ari, very nice.
Darius getting aggressive on Olaf.
We have a lot of movement down at Dragon. Leona is the only one down there aware of what's going on. Ezreal is completely oblivious farming.
Oh, Ezreal nice getting the blue one.
From the Ezreal taking blue. Well done. They had no sight other than them just moving towards.
So they're taking top tower and taking dragon.
Now, actually, trying to look for the dragon there. Blue team does end up taking it. So
that's really dangerous for Team Nobody. They just lost power and they lost dragon.
That's 150 gold per person plus 190 from dragon. So overall, that's 340 gold per person on Abyss, which is going to make a huge swing in gold. It's 30k to 22k at this point, so you have a 7k gold advantage already, and it's not even 20 minutes. That is not a good sign for Team Nobody.
Most of that gold, of course, on Ari. Putting on
his head. Not the person you want to have a gold.
And Ari 1v3s and walks away.
Yep. At this point, nobody is praying for a miracle comeback right now.
Yeah, right now, they need Maxius to get farmed. They need Maxius to get more ahead.
Maxius does a nice job using his ult so that Graves and Tarek cannot dive them under tower.
He's giving away red buffs.
It looks like Diaz is pretty much playing a support now, as he's pretty much just gotten wrecked over half the game. And Kalgor, I don't know what he's trying to pull here. I guess he just wanted protection on his red yesterday.
Maxius saving those blinks for the Terra stun. And they are on about the same amount of a cooldown, so 12 seconds, yeah. So every time Terra tries to stun, he'll just jump away.
Right now, level advantage and gold advantage for blue team. So if nobody doesn't pick it up soon, they will be finding themselves at almost a 10k spread. Nazi is playing extremely aggressive for some reason, capitalizing on it. We have a possible team fight coming down at bottom here. They don't see Ari coming in from behind on the river. It's not a good sign for Tarsus. Tarsus will go down. And Leona and Helga are a little too far up. Ezreal just taking out behind them. Amumu, Ari, Tarek, and Graves all coming in, trying to CG him, takes out Kalgor. On this tower, Amumu is tanking like a boss, going for Leona and taking the kill.
Of course, that was the 4v5 wild day for taking top tower.
And he is trying everything he can.
Oh, it's Pecco.
Gets the kill on Tarek from the tower shot. It looks like Amumu wants to go for the tower, is rallying his team around it. They will take bottom tower.
And the top inner tower.
Top has two teams down at this point. Right now, Team Nobody is over 10k behind Abyss. Abyss is just completely controlling this game at this point. Nobody has to play it smart, has to play it safe, and just basically farm up at this point if they even want to come back on this. And Abyss is doing a nice job at counter jungling. They've completely left Diaz playing Maokai to almost no farm whatsoever, and his level signs of weak, whereas you have two level 15s already on this.
Kalgor walling up
pretty
good at
it. Kalgor has no chance of getting out of that. He's coming in, gets grabbed by Amumu. The CC all around, both teams are doing quite well, and Graves just dunks Ezreal in 3 hits. Nobody just hit him
for one.
Oh, and Graves goes down from a very nice place to touch the ball.
Ari spamming the last. really all that Abyss has to do now is finish out the game.
Hell's Light is going 10-1-9. He's a 19-1 KDA right now, guys. I have to give him credit. If he keeps that, he's still be eligible for the Fever Award of 15-1 KDA.
If you were a Fever member.
I don't know how much Team Nobody is going to handle his first game. They may give up at a certain point here if things don't turn around soon.
I mean, we're picking up a Sunfire, tons of wards, and he's had an Oracle for quite a while.
And a steal of blue buff again, but they have seen Ari. It's doing a firm hand run. He is popping ghosts to get in there for that.
Look how much damage Ezreal took from Ari, too.
He gets caught offside, a 3-on-1. The rest of the team not helping him at all. And he is a 4-on-1, and he goes down phase. But a flash, very aggressive play by Ari here, going balls to the wall. The rest of the team basically walked away, and Ari was left 1-on-3 at that point, if it did turn.
Of course, they have the dragon timer, so it's a free dragon. Yeah. Zeus is not doing very well this game.
Zeus is just getting handed his ass left and right. I mean, his jungle's been countered nonstop this whole game. Every single gank he does is unsuccessful. I mean, he's not holding his end of the deal on the lane captures, so.
There's 16k gold. 16k.
No,
only
16k
now.
5 towers,
every dragon.
Amuru wiping those minions out really fast, actually giving them just a slight lane advantage there.
Going in a little bit too far, but he's an Amuru, so he just walks away.
Yeah. Abyss is trying to make the move, trying to see if somebody's out of place, but luckily nobody gets out of there.
Of course, Arteco, being that support, is still really vulnerable to damage.
Oh,
instigating and Carthus.
Nice coordination from Abyss. Amuru goes down, Tant goes down. Oh, and they are trapped in there. But nobody on Team Nobody are up for 20 seconds at this point, so they are safe for now. They got 10 seconds to clear out of there. They're probably wondering when Bowler is about to come. He has a chance at killing that Darius, but the Darius might get a just enough regen to last.
Nah, he'll be fine. He still has his Hexen to proc up.
Good push by this there. It's taking center map control completely out of nobody's range. So basically, nobody has to stay in their base or move as a team of five to do much of anything in this game anymore. Especially with the level difference. Ari moving up towards Baron will place a green ward just for that little extra sight in the river there. He's also going to probably place a secondary ward in there. It looks like another gathering in middle. Nobody's playing slightly too aggressive for what they have sight, and Terra comes in, takes the stun on. Oh, and Amuru
once again getting caught.
Holds on his ult. Which he doesn't have a bound, so.
That's still on Twitter on the last play.
Hell's Light getting caught by Leona.
Leona going too far in.
Leona goes down. Wow! Wow! Oh, and
Hell's.
Excellent kill from Crisis from Death. They're getting the double and eliminating the push, at least evening the odds slightly for a 4-3 advantage. Algor unaware of the Mumu position just below in lane. Probably a good idea. He's running
for Ezreal. Amuru's bursting him.
Slowed down by Amuru and taken out by the two supporting classes of the game. amazing. He's making a really awkward decision to go in by himself. Thinking he could probably take down Amumu, but Amumu just has too many fancy items to live yet. So this is taking center inhibitor at 28 minutes. So this will give them the super minion pushing power that they need to secure Baron within the 2 minutes.
At this point, they don't even need Baron.
They could just push and win, but they're messing around
yeah.
a little bit.
Just playing it safe. They want to secure the win. They don't want to force the win.
I mean, come on now. Terra's going to move, kill it.
Yeah,
they do
this
have
game has been over for a long time.
Lead, but you do have to understand, even at that much of a lead, you still can screw up mentally when pushing. Because if you have one of your players go down, I mean, that much gold advantage gets cut off. So, I mean, if one person on your team has like 15, 20 gold, you know, take that off the total gold amount, and that's about where they're sitting when they do a team fight. So.
And right now, if somebody's going to save them, it has to be Karthus.
And Noxus moving in. He's the art. Tries to escape. Oh, and a nice blink. Really getting out of there. Arya going balls to the wall, gets caught by Leona.
And
Jade comes
in
and gets a clean house. Hell's Way is Arya. Giving Jade a triple kill going into the base, and this may be game if the minion wave pushes up.
I don't think they can take
it. Terra's doing a nice job of attacking bottom lane towers. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to push it with that wave alone, but he's going to continue pushing bottom as the rest of the team.
The flash pull.
Power dive onto Karthus. Jayden is going all in. Amazing play by Abyss. They are just creaming Team Nobody on almost every corner of this game. Not sure if it's the best option to put down his tower, but they do take it, and they do have two people at half health, but Terra comes out. He is dropping right away in the team fight. Ooh, and it's Grade. Grade's taking down two. Moomoo taking the third kill, and Noxus gets barely away. Oh, but Grade
picking up
Ezreal all the way into the fountain, gets the ace. Wow.
I'll cut out on that note.
Oh, and a lack of attention from Aztec and Amumu. Oh, Aztec does have it all, so this is game over for Amumu.
Bye bye, Oracle.
Well played section by Fulton there, but it's not enough for them just to continue pushing. Maokai does attempt to put his ult in the area, trying to force, you know, Abyss to hit him, but doesn't actually get the damage off from his ult onto. I'm not understanding why nobody is separating their force going in instead of just basically keeping the lane secured. Helgor,
Over.
Going for the massive damage with Ezreal straight behind him. Ezreal gets in there and does the damage. Yes, they land the kill. The Hellblade is running away with a small amount of health. Hits a nice 2 damage shot on the Nox. Nox basically pulling under. Misses the shot and
Taken
out. Jay is just out of place to land the kill there for Ari. Looks like Terra's is signaling for a steal on red, but they may be getting a little too greedy for their wants. They've lowered their lead by just a small margin. But
at this point, I consider the whole jungle their jungle.
Considering
nobody barely even has a base. They have an inhibitor and an extra.
They're top lane inhibitor right here.
They have so much lockdown power that they can stop Darius, kill him, and not worry about it, just like that.
Yep.
And that is your team nobody banned.
And that's what the moon is quite feel.
Unless
but that's
ICO gets that kick ass all down the bearing lane.
Unless
fire away.
Three more to go, Terran.
Mumu
fighting. So close to the ceiling.
Yeah,
so he's only about
500 health off. That's too bad. I'm not easy right there. They're just gonna push in and take the next route.
Yeah, they got burned and it was a 4-for-1 trade, so Abyss comes way out ahead on that burn buff.
Of course, Scott stopping for some race, because CS always looks good on the scorecard.
And it looks like they're gonna do all lanes pushing up. Noxus just doesn't have enough power to take on three people at once. Very good at single target play, but when you start adding in the multi target, you've got to play more of an AP style game.
Yo, Polly.
What's up?
What's your own game name? Is Polly.
550.
Polly 550?
Yeah. We're still watching the game.
Maybe not.
I see. I see that.
It's Polly 550, right?
Close to a bit.
Yeah. What's that? Yeah, so keep moving around. I'm gonna invite Polly. Grab the Polly and take it.
Yep.
I'm gonna spectate.